An ionic bond is what holds ions together. So what's important when we are talking about ionic is understanding that it is a process. And we'll get more into the details of this. But the attraction here, or the bond, is the attraction between a positive cation and a negative anion. To make our cations and anions, we have a process that occurs. In an ionic compound, you're going to have a large difference in electronegativity. It's going to be greater than 2. That means one thing, our nonmetal, has a much higher attraction for electrons than our metal. With sodium and chlorine coming back up here, we have 3.0, we have 0.9. That is a 2.1 difference. That's big enough that not only are they sharing, but chlorine is totally gaining the electron, the sodium totally loses it. That exchange of electrons is important, and it actually happens in a few steps that we'll see coming up, but it is the attraction between the cation and anion that is the bond itself, and something that makes ionic different than, very importantly so, than covalent, is we often, it doesn't end up as just one attraction between this atom and this atom, or this ion and this ion. It ends up in a repeating network or a repeating structure, a crystal of alternating cations and anions. So this often happens when we have a metal with a nonmetal. When we have two nonmetals, that most commonly results in polar or nonpolar covalent. When we have a metal and nonmetal, that is ionic. And really drawing that line, that 2.0, sometimes an ionic might be right on that borderline, even slightly less than 2. But when we have a metal with a nonmetal, we look at the properties. And if the properties match up with other ionic properties, we would consider that to be an ionic bond.